Good morning, children. So we will be continuing with chapter 13, the use of tense. Okay, now let's come to the present continuous is used to express an action going on at the time of speaking. He is writing a letter. The boy are playing hockey. So present continuous will be continued with ing. Okay, to indicate an action that is planned to take place in near future. I am going to Mumbai tomorrow. She is coming here in the evening. To describe an action which may not be actually going on at the time of speaking but is still related to present time. I am playing cricket these days. We are learning English grammar at school. So, to describe an action which is actually going on at time of speaking. Okay. So now, these are some works which I'll be giving you. Okay. Now let's move on to the present perfect is used. To denote an action that has just been completed. He has solved the sum. They have reached home safely. To express a past experience, the time of which is not given. I have seen the Taj. I have studied in school. So these are perfect, present perfect. Okay, which has denote action that has just been completed, like he has solved the sum. So just the action has been completed. So here is, they have reached home safely. The task have been completed of reaching home safely. I have seen the Taj. So he had already seen the Taj. I have studied this in this school. So it is already done, which expresses the action which has been completed. So let's move on to describe some past event with a result now. So it also describes some past event which also in results now. I have already seen this film. I don't want to see it again. Doctor have gone on strike. The situation is serious. To show a past action as continuing up to the present. We have lived here for 10 years. We are still living here. So now the past action which is continuing up. Okay. He has been ill since last week. So from it is the past is continuing. Okay. Like he. So the past indefinite is used. So what is past indefinite? To denote an action in the past. We learned English at school. We played a match last Sunday. So it is defining a past. Okay. So to denote a habitual action in the past. This is the action in the past. This is habitual action in the past. My granny never told lies. So these are lies. Okay, truth. These are habitual actions. He came to our house every evening. So every evening, what are these are habits? Like every evening we go to work. Oh, he came to our house every morning. So these are habitual works. Okay. To denote action going on in the past. So while they danced, we sang. So action, that is dancing is an action. Okay, singing is an action. So this is denoting some action which is going on in the past. So while they danced, we sang. While they were dancing, we were singing. So the main points to remember here is we can't use present perfect with adverb denotation denoting past time. He came here yesterday. He reached home last night. So these are the points that used in present perfect denoting the past time. Okay, note the difference. We have lived here for 10 years. We lived here for 10 years. So these are the materials which I am going to give you. Okay. So now let's move on to past perfect. What is past perfect? To say that some actions has taken place before another began to complete. Began or complete. Here the action that took place first takes the past perfect form. And action that took place later takes the past indefinite form. It started raining after she had left. I had written the letter before he arrived. I had done my homework when Nidhi came to see me. टू एक्सप्रेस सम अनफुलफिल्ड डिजायर आई विश आई हैड वर्कड हार्डर फॉर द एग्जाम दिस आर पास परफेक्ट टेंस विच सेज सम एक्शन टेकन प्लेस इन अनदर एंड बिगैन और कंप्लीटेड ओके सो द एक्शन टेक्स फर्स्ट ओके टुक द प्लेस फर्स्ट देन टेक्स द पास्ट परफेक्ट फॉर्म सो हियर पास्ट स्टार्टेड रेनिंग आफ्टर शी हैड लेफ्ट ओके आई हैड रिटन द लेटर बिफोर ही अराइव सो द एक्शन टेक्स प्लेस एट द पास्ट सो अनदर पॉइंट इज टू एक्सप्रेस अनफुलफिल्ड डिजायर आई विश आई हैड वर्कड हार्डर फॉर द एग्जाम अनफुलफिल्ड डिजायर Here is the future indefinite. Future indefinite, I shall see him tomorrow. They will reach here in the evening. The future continuous is, we shall be taking our exam next month. I will be sleeping when you came back at night. Indicate some future plan. We shall be staying here for a week. Now I shall be visiting this place regularly. The future perfect is used. I shall have finished my work by 7 o'clock. So these are future indefinite, which denotes the action which still take place. Future continuous, which denotes the action is going on at some point in future. Future perfect is to indicate completion of the action of certain time in future. Okay.